2, verse 14. First verse 4. For out of much affliction and anguish of heart, I wrote unto you with many tears, not that you should be grieved, but that ye might know the love which I have more abundantly unto you. 2 Corinthians 2, 14 says, now thanks be unto God,
yes,
which causes us to triumph in Christ and maketh manifest the savor of his knowledge by us in every place. Chapter 4. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels,
yeah,
that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our body. For we which live are always delivered unto death for Jesus' sake, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our mortal flesh. So then death worketh in us, but life in you. We have the same spirit of faith, according as it is written, I believe, and therefore have I spoken. We also believe, and therefore speak, knowing that he which raised up the Lord Jesus shall raise up us also by Jesus, and shall present us with you. For all things are for your sakes, that the abundant grace might through the thanksgiving of many redound to the glory of God. For which cause we faint not, but though our outward man perish, yet the inward man is renewed day by day. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory.
Yes.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Just a little small subject. Amen. Just to talk real briefly. Amen. It wasn't meant to break me, but to make me.
All right. That's good.
Amen. It wasn't meant to break me, but to make me.
Yes.
Amen. Make means to form or to put together or to construct or to create. Amen. But the one that I like is to cause to exist or come about. Amen. Break means to separate or cause to separate into pieces. Amen. But the part that I like is interrupt or disturb.
My
Amen.
God.
It wasn't meant to interrupt me or disturb me.
What?
But it was made to cause me to exist or to come about. Here, amen, the word of the Lord in the book of Corinthians, amen. Paul is talking, amen, to the Corinthian church, and he wrote them a letter, amen. It said, but I determined this with myself, that I would not come again to you in heaviness, amen. Even though, amen, we're going through our certain situations and circumstances that we face, amen, praise the Lord, I didn't come to make you feel bad.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Paul began to say, I didn't come to make you feel sorry for me, amen, praise the Lord, but I came to let you know, hallelujah, the love which I have more abundantly unto you is to let you know, amen, that it didn't come to break me, but it came to make me.
Yeah.
Amen, praise the Lord. We suffer many things, amen, sufficient, amen, to such a man, this punishment which was inflicted of many. Amen. Praise the Lord. The word of the Lord tells us that contrarywise, you ought rather to forgive and comfort. Amen. Praise the Lord. We have things that come up against us. We have folks that come up against us. Amen. Praise the Lord. We have trials that we must face. Amen. Praise the Lord. But they didn't come to break us. They came to make us. Amen. They came to cause us to exist when we were in a place of non-existence. Hallelujah. Amen. We find ourselves getting comfortable in our state of being. Amen. Hallelujah. We find ourselves disappearing. Amen. Praise the Lord behind the chaos of the world. Amen. Glory to God. But the word of the Lord declares. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. That if we cast our cares on him. Amen. Because he cares for us. Amen. Praise the Lord. These little things that we face. Amen. These little afflictions that we go through. Amen. Glory to God. They didn't come to break us, but they came to make us. Amen. The word of the Lord here. Amen. In 2 Corinthians Corinthians and the fourth chapter. Yes. Amen. Began to tell us, therefore, see, we have this ministry. Amen. As we have received mercy, we faint not. Yes. Amen. Don't get weary in well doing. Amen. Glory to God, the word of the Lord. Amen. Will tell us that we can triumph. Amen. Glory to God that we have victory. Amen. Glory to God over the enemy and our circumstances. Amen. I found a quote that says victory belongs to you. Amen. To every believer, no matter what kind of affliction or persecution. Amen. That you face. Amen. In the mind of God, the end result is, church, you still got victory. Amen. You can give up before victory comes. Amen. You can get weary in your well-doing before victory comes. Amen. We can get discouraged, hallelujah, and want to quit. Amen. All before victory comes. Amen. But the word of the Lord declares, amen, that the devil is a defeated foe. And we already have the victory. Amen. Because there's a treasure down on the inside.
Go ahead.
That exceeding excellency of power, amen, that may be of God, and none of us have found out, we can't do anything of our own selves, amen, the word of the Lord declares, amen, that we ought to lean not to our own understanding, all of our ways, we ought to acknowledge God, hallelujah, I feel like telling the church, God, hallelujah, that we are troubled on every side, but yet not in distress. We are perplexed, but not in despair. We've been persecuted, but not forsaken. We've been cast down, but not destroyed. You've got to remember, we're not being broken, hallelujah, to destroy us. Amen, but we're being made that we can come forth as pure gold. Amen. The word of the Lord declares in the book of Romans, the 8th chapter. Clap your hands and give God glory. Thank you, Jesus. That we're not being broken. Hallelujah. We're not being broken. Hallelujah. But we're being made. In the book of Romans, and the 8th chapter, and the 28th verse says, and we know that all things, they work together to the good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose. And the Bible declares, hallelujah, for whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to conform to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many. I come to tell you, saints of God, it wasn't sent to break us. It wasn't
sent Go ahead.
It wasn't sent to cause us to give up. It wasn't sent to cause us to throw in the towel. But it was God's going to make us strong. It was sent that we could hold on and hold on a little tighter to get a little closer to God. Thank you, Jesus. I come to tell the saints of God. Hallelujah. According to John 10 and 10, the Bible declares that the enemy coming to steal and to steal and to destroy. Even the God came that we might have life, that we might have it more abundantly. I came to tell you today, I might be going through now. I might be being afflicted now. But this light affliction is but for a moment. Hallelujah. I decided I'd go through. Amen. I decided I'd hold on. I decided I'd hold out until God makes a way. Yeah. and tell me I've got you. Amen. Glory to God. And in my study, I heard the word the Lord say, you can walk in like the lion, but you ought to fight like David, because it didn't come to break you, but it came to make you. When the lion came up against David, and the Philistines came up against his brothers, amen, to call them to give up on what they heard, on what they saw. Little old David said, wait a minute, I'll go. Thank you, Jesus. I'll go up against the giant. But I come to tell you, saints, if you just hold out, if you just hold on, God is going to work it out. Work it out.
That's all right.
He's going to work it out. It didn't come to break you. When you go through and when you suffer,
yes,
you got to suffer for Christ's sake.
All right, right.
When you're going through, mm-hmm, can't go through with mumbling and grumbling and murmuring and complaining.
Right.
Hallelujah. Amen. But I decided I'd go through with praise.
Yes.
I decided I'd go through with some joy.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I decided I would allow God to just go ahead and do what he wants to do in me. Sometimes that's not a good place.
That's right.
Sometimes it doesn't feel good.
Don't feel good.
Hallelujah. But I'm reminded of what I asked God. Mm-hmm. I said, make me the vessel that you would have me to be. Amen. That would be honorable and pleasing in your sight. Amen. Praise the Lord. And he took me down, amen, to the prophet Jeremiah. Told me, amen, go and watch. Amen. The potter on the wheel. When you're being made, you're being broken. Amen. You're being fixed and you're being formed. It's not to break you and to cause you to give up on God, but it's to make you who you profess to be. It's to make you the person that God had called and appointed you to be. Amen. Praise the Lord. And so I accept my affliction because in the end, hallelujah, the anointing shall be greater. Hallelujah. I give God praise. The blessings of God will overtake us.
Amen.
If we hold out and hold on to God, go through, hallelujah, what you're going through. But just know that it didn't come to break you, but it came to make you.
Hallelujah.